the rocket. We will rock you. Get on your feet. Disgrace. Oh, we will rock you. Well, folks, as you can see, that song, we will rock you, is what the farmers are doing. Things are getting tricky. There's news that finally the big three, the HM, the Raksha Mantri, and the Prime Minister are meeting before the meeting with the unions of the Kisans. Maybe there is something a brew. Maybe there's a proposal on the table. However, the stance is hardened. Farmers up ante call for Bharat Bandh on December 8th. Repeal laws or we may break off talks midway. You know, all trust has been lost. And you know, there is obviously a group of people who say that, you know, if the government gives in, then all the other laws will be at stake. But then, you know, at the end of the day, what the government has to learn is this: there has to be discussion, there has to be a two-way talk before they can make laws, right? Here again, Tejaswi backs farmers' protest to lead dharna in Patna today. But the BJP guys, you know their DNA, right? They're not with it, right? Whether it's Khattar, whether it's Madhya Pradesh Chauhan, whether it's... So here's another one. Farmer protests only in Punjab. Most are Congress workers, MOS agriculture. Now somebody should tell the stupid guy, if Congress had all that money to mobilize such a huge number of people, I'm not sure they would have just ended up with 52 people in the parliament, folks. Thing to remember, what does Mamta say? Mamta warns of nationwide protests, right? However, the two disconcerting things are take up Punjab issue with India, 36 MPs write to US UK Foreign Secretary. These are both conservatives and the Labour Party. India summons Canadian High Commissioner, issues Dimake over Trudeau remark on farmers. India hands Dimake over Trudeau farmers remarks, right? Now, here's the deal, folks. Ordinarily, I would say both these countries have every right to talk about India's democratic credentials and ask for fair, allowing fair and free pradarshans, sangharsh jada ho raha hai. But both these countries, unfortunately, have a duplicitous, dubious past, as using the cloak of freedom, personal freedom, democracy, they've both allowed extreme elements of Islam and Khalistan to grow and to function in those two countries. Who can forget the Kanishka? We should actually never forget the Kanishka, because till today, nothing really has come out of that, which actually tells me, it goes to show that maybe the Canadian government was part of the whole plot. Who knows, right? Just because of that, the way they handled the investigation and subsequent nailing of the culprits just goes to show they were really not serious, right? So their hands are actually blooded, right? And same thing, whether you see the Kashmir issue and whether you see how Britain has harbored extreme Islamic preachers, allowed them to continue preaching. Actually, it's not a blowback is happening in their countries, and it's kind of, I guess, it's payback time. Hey. Well, look what else is happening. BJP emerges as a major force in Hyderabad, TRS largest party. I suggest the BJP stop celebrating. They're expanding way beyond their ability, because in their bastion, looks what happens. Boom! Jolt for BJP in Maharashtra wins just 1 out of 5 seats. Yeah. Now, what's happening in Haryana, also interesting, will bring no confidence motion against BJP. JJP government says, Huda. Things not so good. Families... In our personal lives, families keep low profiles as cops stop interfaith wedding. We have a much bigger things to do. We've always said that the MCD is corrupt and it's been held by the BJP for the last 15 years. BJP councillors arrested for accepting bribe of rupees 10 lakhs. Then what do we have? Failing businesses pay lakhs to get back migrants. This is in Bombay. That's really, really interesting. The Friday sales, which is the make or break for seasons in the United States, bleak Friday as shoppers choose to buy online and stores stay empty. This is this V-shaped recovery is losing steam, folks. But interest in India keeps going. Global investors, local rivals place 60 bids for our cap assets, folks. Cheers to that.